by, hopefully at 3:30, by a light refreshment. Those of you who have hopefully at 3:30, by a light refreshment. Those of you who have small children who would rather prefer to be outside than inside, feel free to go out, but make sure you return here by 3:30 for the refreshment. I won't miss it for anything. The last part, which is the cultural program, will begin at 4 o'clock, not at 4:30, which might have been in some invitation letters. It will begin at 4 o'clock and is expected to last for about an hour and a half. So we hope this function will conclude this afternoon at 5:30 p.m. Before I invite Dr. Rahman of the university to present to you and address a welcome, I would like to say a few words myself on the hopes and aspirations of the Bangladeshi community in this area. The Bangladeshi community in northeast of Scotland is probably the largest ethnic minority community in this area, and this is the first time we are celebrating our National Independence Day. We decided to use this occasion to foster harmony and greater understanding between ourselves and the host community within which we live. The Bangladeshi Association in Northeast of Scotland has been formed several years ago, and ever since it has been very active. Its objectives are to provide a focus of identity to the Bangladeshi people in this area, and also to assist them to integrate better with the community outside. With these twin objectives in mind, the association wishes to establish a Bangladesh Cultural Center and a Sunday school here. Although the Bangladeshis are by nature very law abiding, there is a danger, all too evident, that young Bangladeshis in this area who do not have any family ties might, out of sheer boredom, succumb to the vices which surround us all. To counteract that, it is proposed that we should have a Bangladesh center which would provide them with an alternative for something better to do. In the Sunday school, we naturally hope to teach our children something of our home culture. But this is only one of several other things we have in mind. We wish to give them, our children, special lessons on the Scottish culture and custom, and also on the English language, and particularly to the housewives. Most of them are not exposed to outside. It is our hope that with this, they would be better prepared to mix with the society outside. Through this school, we also wish to assist our children in their school homework. In view of their essentially non-speaking home life, non-English speaking home life, they often find it very difficult to understand school homework and to complete them satisfactorily, which in turn retard their progress in school. We would like to help to rectify this situation. Many of you here would obviously know of the recently published Swan Report, which discusses some of the related issues on education. Thus, through the Bangladesh Center and the Sunday School, the association wished to give the Bangladeshis here a sense of identity and a confidence so that they can become better citizens in this country. Our community is committed to these objectives I have described. Although most of our members are low paid, we believe in self-reliance and we are prepared to make financial contributions. But we also know that our own contributions only would not be enough to achieve these objectives. In this connection, I am pleased to say that the Grampian Regional Council has already provided us with a venue for Sunday school, and it is currently considering in providing us with some financial assistance towards the running cost of this school. I also know that Aberdeen District Council is very sympathetic to our needs. We naturally appreciate these gestures. Coming back to the community in which we live, many of us have lived here for a number of years, and over these years, the coldness and harshness of the Aberdonian weather, just think of yesterday, have been amply compensated by the warmth and generosity of the Aberdonian people. In return, we ourselves would like to play our role in enriching the social, cultural, and economic life of the community, the wider community in this part of Scotland. This is all I wish to say. Thank you very much.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome you all to this 14th anniversary of the National and Independence Day celebration of Bangladesh in Aberdeen. We are pleased to have amongst ourselves this afternoon His Excellency the High Commissioner of Bangladesh, Mr. Fakhruddin Ahmed, the Lord Provost of Aberdeen, Councillor Henry Ray, Councillor Bob Middleton of the Grampian Regional Council, Chief Constable of Grampian Region, Mr. Lean, Professor Robert Moore, the Chairman of Grampian Community Relations Council, and all its members who are present here, Mr. Rasool, Chairman of the Federation of Bangladesh Associations in UK and Europe, amongst others. It is a great pleasure to see so many Bangladeshi faces, particularly children, here this afternoon, and we are heartened as well to see the host community presented here in such a nice way. I welcome you all here this afternoon. I take this opportunity to highlight some of the aspects of Bangladesh life which probably does not percolate through the barriers of the media and the priorities that is set by the international political problems. And I wish to put in perspective this afternoon's proceedings with the corresponding life in Bangladesh. This brochure here highlights or includes some of the statistics and relevant information about Bangladesh, and I do not want to repeat those. What I would like to do is to deal with some other aspects of Bangladeshi life. The general information about Bangladesh that reaches the ordinary people in Britain and outside in the West in general is mostly through the mass media, the local press, newspaper, radio, and television. The picture that emerges is unfortunately one of natural calamities, poverty, political uncertainty, and overpopulation, and to some, even lack of hope. Though there is some truth in all these, it is far from being the complete truth. To most visitors and to Bangladeshis in Bangladesh, Bangladesh is a country of enormous color and spectrum, culturally rich, politically vibrant, and full of life force, humor, and above all, hope. It has a history of political turmoil and uncertainty, but at every major crisis and every turning point of history, historical decision making, the ordinary people of Bangladesh have asserted their political will judiciously. Though the Western world may not know as well the process and the fight by the Bangladeshis for their independence, particularly during the 1969 and 71 period, was it one of the most glorious struggles in the history of modern day liberation movements anywhere in the world. Historically, the political and the philosophical leadership of the Indian subcontinent was often given by the people from what is now geographically called Bangladesh. Turning to the question of culture, Bangladesh has a very rich culture indeed. I hope the music and the dance of this afternoon will probably give you a touch of the varied and rich culture that is existent there. The contribution of Bangladesh music to the musical culture of the East in general is enormous. Bangladesh's contribution to the folk, modern, neoclassical and classical music, both in the fields of instrument and vocal music, is very significant. Poetry is a special feature in Bangladeshi culture. There is a saying in Bangladesh that everybody writes poetry in Bangladesh. Another saying, quite common in Bangladesh, that when you fall in love, you write a poem. When you fall out of love, you write a poem. And when you are jilted, you write another. Bangladesh is probably one of the very few places in the world where poets can make a very good living out of writing poetry. One of the greatest poets of Bangladesh, internationally known, is Rabindranath Tagore, who won Nobel Prize in the 1910 period. But for his famous work called Gitanjali, which is by no means his best work. Tagore has the rare distinction of being a poet whose 100th anniversary was celebrated at the United Nations. To give a different example of the Bangladesh culture nearer to us, to our palate, the so-called Indian restaurants, out of that at least 70% in UK, are owned and run by Bangladeshis. The wide variety and the excellent food served there is only a small portion of the highly developed culinary expertise that is present and widespread in Bangladesh. There is a school of development experts who tend to attribute to the underdevelopment of some of the developing countries and say that the underdevelopment of those countries is because the people do not work hard. There cannot be any myth or any idea further from truth. In Bangladesh, more than 80% people live in villages. And they work extremely hard indeed. And just to meet their livelihood, they have to work 16 to 18 hours a day, 365 days a year. Enormous amount of hard work every day by most people, particularly by the contribution of the rural women who have a major contribution to the economy. And I thought these were one or two myths that had to be cleared. Very often, the rural poor, the urban poor, the landless laborers there are in a vicious poverty trap and what has been called by experts as energy trap. Yes, like most societies, there is an idle, parasitic rich minority, some of whom also control the decision-making processes to an extent. But this occasion is neither the place nor the situation to discuss development strategy of Bangladesh or policy priorities. The point I'm trying to make here this afternoon, that Bangladeshis are very hard-working people indeed. And their life is full of hope, endowed with a deep-rooted sense of self-respect. It is these aspects of Bangladesh's life, hope, self-respect, and a very deep-rooted oriental sense of honor, which the expatriate Bangladeshis hope to carry with them and bring and contribute to the communities where they hope to start their own life and which one they intend to make their home. And it is these aspects of life who definitely contribute to the richness of the multicultural society of Britain today. With this note of hope, I would welcome you all to this afternoon proceedings, and thank you very much.
Address.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First of all, I should correct my name. My name is S. A. Rasool. I will also take this indulgence from the chairman to speak in Bengali as well as in English, because in the presence of the audience, which is most of them are Bangladeshis, I would rather like to speak in Bengali, which is my mother tongue. And for the convenience of my host community, I would like to address something in English which I feel that they should know. তো প্রথমে আমি আমার ভাইদের বোনেদের জন্য বাংলায় কিছু বলব। আপনারা আজ আমাকে এখানে উপস্থিত থাকতে বলেছেন, দাওয়াত করেছেন, তার জন্য আমি আপনাদের ধন্যবাদ জানাই। আমি অ্যাবারডিনে আগেও এসেছি, আজকেও আসলাম। এই উপলক্ষে আমি কয়েকটা কথা শুধু বলতে চাই। প্রথমত, সংগ্রাম আমরা করেছি বাংলাদেশকে স্বাধীন করার জন্য। আপনারা সবাই এই সংগ্রামে জড়িত ছিলেন, প্রবাসী বাঙালি আমরা সবাই জড়িত ছিলাম। এই সংগ্রামের মাধ্যমে আমরা বাংলাদেশ পেয়েছি, কিন্তু তার পরিপ্রেক্ষিতে অনেক আমাদের প্রাণ দিতে হয়েছে, আমাদের মা বোনেদের ইজ্জত দিতে হয়েছে, আমাদের অনেকেরই বাড়ি ঘর দর নষ্ট হয়েছে, সবকিছুই আমরা বিসর্জন দিয়েছি। এর জন্য আমরা এর মাধ্যমে পেয়েছি বাংলাদেশ, এবং সেই বাংলাদেশের আজকে চতুর্দশ বার্ষিকীতে আমরা সমবেত হয়েছি। এটা আমাদের একটা সৌভাগ্য, কারণ বিদেশে থেকেও আমরা এর সঙ্গে জড়িত হতে পারছি। আমরা চাইব যে বাংলাদেশ আরো উন্নতি হোক, আরো আগে বাড়ুক। আমাদের ছেলে মেয়ে যারা এদেশে জন্ম নিচ্ছে বা এদেশে আছে, তাদেরকে আমরা আমাদের দেশের সম্বন্ধে, আমাদের সংস্কৃতির সম্বন্ধে, আমাদের ভাষার সম্বন্ধে তাদেরকে জ্ঞান দেব, যাতে করে তারাও বড় হয়ে বাংলাদেশের সম্বন্ধে তারা জানে, তাদের ভাষা জানে, তাদের সংস্কৃতি জানে। এর সঙ্গে সঙ্গে আমি আরেকটু কথা বলতে চাই, সেটা হলো বাংলাদেশ সংগ্রামের সময় আপনাদের মতো আমি নিজেও ওতপ্রোতভাবে জড়িত ছিলাম। এই দেশে তখন এই দেশের জনসাধারণ, এই দেশের রেডিও টেলিভিশন পত্রিকা সকলেই আমাদের সাহায্য করেছেন, এবং এই উপলক্ষে আমি তাদেরকে ধন্যবাদ দিতে চাই। কারণ আমরা বিশ্বের মাধ্যমে যে আমরা সংগ্রামের প্রচার পেয়েছিলাম, যে সাহায্য সহানুভূতি সহযোগিতা পেয়েছি, যার মাধ্যমে আমরা বাংলাদেশ সম্ভব হয়েছে, সেটা সম্ভব হতো না যদি কিনা আমরা ব্রিটেনে থেকে, বিলাতে থেকে আমরা এই সংগ্রামের জন্য বিশ্বের কাছে আমাদের এই প্রচার তুলে ধরতে পারতাম। দ্বিতীয় আরেকটা কথা যেটা আমি বলতে চাচ্ছি সেটা হলো যে বাংলাদেশ যখন প্রথম আমরা পাই তখন এই দেশের থেকে আমরা অনেক সাহায্য পেয়েছি, যেমন ধরুন ওয়ারেন ওয়ান্ট, যা অক্সফ্যাম, ক্রিশ্চান এড, রেড ক্রস, বিভিন্ন ব্রিটিশ চ্যারিটির থেকে আমরা অনেক সাহায্য পেয়েছি, বা বিভিন্ন লোকজনও তাদের মাধ্যমে আমাদের দেশকে সাহায্য করেছেন। এই উপলক্ষে আমি তাদেরও ধন্যবাদ জানাই এবং আজকেও তারা অনেকেই সাহায্য করছেন। এই হলো প্রথম দুইটা কথা আমার। আর দুটো কথা যেটা আমি বলবো সেটা হলো বহিরাগতদের সমস্যার ব্যাপারে। আপনারা যারা এখানে পরিবারবর্গ নিয়ে আছেন তারা সত্যিকারের সৌভাগ্য, কিন্তু অনেকেই যারা এখানে তাদের পরিবারবর্গ আনতে পারেন নাই তাদের একটা সবচেয়ে বড় সমস্যা। আর সমস্যার আরেকটা কারণ হলো যে ব্রিটিশ সরকারের ইমিগ্রেশন রুল, নিয়মকানুন এতই জঘন্য, যার মাধ্যমে আপনাদের থেকে আপনাদের পরিবারবর্গকে বিচ্ছিন্ন করে রাখা হয়েছে। এই মাসের দুইটো ঘটনা খুবই উল্লেখযোগ্য। একটা ঘটনা ঘটেছে 19 মার্চ, গার্ডিয়ান পত্রিকার মাধ্যমে আমরা জানতে পারলাম যে হোম অফিস থেকে, অর্থাৎ কিনা ডেভিড ওয়াডিংটন সাহেবের মন্ত্রিত্বের থেকে, একটা ইনস্ট্রাকশন, নির্দেশ দেওয়া হয়েছিল এন্ট্রি সার্টিফিকেট অফিসারদেরকে ঢাকাতেও, যে তোমরা ইচ্ছাকৃতভাবে যাতে করে দেশের থেকে পরিবারবর্গ, পোষ্যবর্গ না আসতে পারে তার ব্যবস্থা করো। অর্থাৎ কিনা এন্ট্রি সার্টিফিকেট দেওয়াটা একটু আস্তে করে দাও, যার ফলে দেখা যায় যে জুন মাসের 1983 থেকে আরম্ভ করে হঠাৎ করে এন্ট্রি সার্টিফিকেটের সংখ্যার, বাতিলের সংখ্যা অনেক বেড়ে গেল, এবং এই বাতিলের সংখ্যার বাড়ার পরে অনেকেই পরিবারবর্গ আপনারা আনতে পারেন না, এবং আজকে এরকম এখনো চলছে। এটা একটা খুবই বড় দুর্ভাগ্য আমাদের জন্য। এর জন্য অবশ্য ফেডারেশন থেকে আমরা যথেষ্ট আপত্তি করেছি এবং করেও যাব, তবে ইনশাল্লাহ আমরা একথা শুনব না সরকারের এবং এর জন্য আমরা প্রতিবাদ করে যাব। দ্বিতীয় আরেকটি ঘটনা যেটা আমি ইংরেজিতে ওনাদেরকে বলবো সেটা হলো যে মাতৃভাষার শিক্ষার জন্য আপনাদের দাবি যেটা, কারণ সম্প্রতি আপনাদের সভাপতি সাহেব যে কথা একটু আগে বলে গেছেন যে এই মাসে আরেকটা ঘটনা উল্লেখযোগ্য, সেটা হলো 14 মার্চ যেটা ঘটেছে, সেটা হলো যে সোয়ান কমিটির রিপোর্ট প্রকাশিত হয়েছে। এই রিপোর্টের মাধ্যমে বলা হয়েছে যে সংস্কৃতি এবং ভাষা বহিরাগতদের শিক্ষার জন্য ব্যবস্থা করতে হবে, যেহেতু তাদের ভাষা বাচ্চাদের শিক্ষার অত্যন্ত প্রয়োজন। এবং সেখানে বলা হয়েছে যে কর্তৃপক্ষের মারফতে, শিক্ষা কর্তৃপক্ষ অর্থাৎ কিন এডুকেশন অথরিটিস থেকে তাদেরকে সাহায্য দিতে হবে টাকা পয়সা দিয়ে এবং স্কুল চালানোর জন্য কমিউনিটির গ্রুপের মাধ্যমে। যেমন আপনারা এখানে চাচ্ছেন যে আপনাদের অর্গানাইজেশন থেকে টাকা পয়সা যাতে দেওয়া হয় শিক্ষা কর্তৃপক্ষকে বলছেন, আমরাও সেটা চাই যে সোয়ান কমিটির যে রিপোর্ট হয়েছে সেই রিপোর্ট থেকে আপনারা এই সাহায্যটা পেতে পারেন। আরেকটি কথা যেটা আমি বলতে চাই সেটা হলো যে আজকের যে আমাদের এই মিটিংয়ের পরে যে ঘটনাটা ঘটবে সেটা হবে দিশরী শিল্প গোষ্ঠীর পক্ষ থেকে আপনারা যে গান বাজনার সুযোগ পাবেন। দিশরী শিল্পী গোষ্ঠী লন্ডনের বিখ্যাত একটি শিল্পী গোষ্ঠী যারা নাচ গান বাজনা খুব নাম করা করেছেন। আমি সেই ইস্ট লন্ডন থেকে আসছি যেখানে আমার বন্ধু বান্ধবেরা দিশরী শিল্প গোষ্ঠীর থেকে আসছেন, এবং তাদের আপনারা নিশ্চয়ই দেখতে পাবেন, শুনতে পাবেন তারা কি করেন, কারণ এরাও অনেক সময় অনেক আমাদের সাহায্য করেছেন এবং ভাষা এবং সংস্কৃতি দুটোই জাগিয়ে রাখতে অনেক সাহায্য করে যাচ্ছেন। Now I want to switch over to English, if I take this indulgence. The two things I would like to say on this first occasion, at the time of our liberation movement, ladies and gentlemen, many of you have helped us in fighting for our liberation. And I would like to thank the British public, the press and the media who have given us the publicity and gave us the support which we needed at that time. Many of you who have helped in the parliament, the politicians, the members of the ordinary people, as well as the British charities who have given us the support in building the country. There are also those who have given us the guidance and have helped in many ways. The two other points which I would like to raise on this map today are the two important events that has happened in this month. One is I am referring, which took place on the 19th of March, the appearance of a report in The Guardian which mentioned about the internal instruction by the Home Office, where it says that an instruction was issued by the Home Secretary, particularly Minister of State, asking the immigration anti-certificate officers to make administrative delay for the issuing of entry certificates for the dependents and wives who have the statutory right to come to Britain. And this is as a result of that we have found since June 1983 that many of these families who were wanting to come from Bangladesh have been delayed for years, and some of those people are in Aberdeen as well, because many of them who haven't got their families here as well, because I in every day are helping the people all over the country, including Europe, and we know the situation, and I'm telling you because these are the facts. So this is a matter which is highly undesirable. It is inhuman. This is violation of human rights, violation of UN Charter, violation of ILO. We have protested, and I hope the present, those who are in the authorities, will also help us and support us on this. The second point, which is equally important, is the fact that on the 14th of this month, the Swan Committee for Education of All, for All, published their report. And that is equally very important for the education of ethnic minorities. And I'm particularly referring here on the question of the teaching of mother tongue to the ethnic minorities. It makes an obligation on the part of the local education authorities here that the community organizations be given funds, facilities and support to run the mother tongue classes, because the Swan Committee have not supported the running such classes within the school's mainstream, and particularly for the primary age group. So I know that the Aberdeen Bangladesh Association, or the East Scotland Bangladesh Association, have applied for a grant, and I'm sure Councillor Middleton here and the Lord Provost here also would know, and we'd like to see that with your support that the local Bangladesh Association to get this grant and the support to teach Bengali to our children. And finally, I will hope that we, our people, are here to stay, and they are making a special contribution to the community here. And Britain being a multiracial society, I would like to see that they are given the equal opportunities at every aspect and every field, and I mean it, that should be, because it's your responsibility to see they are treated equally. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Rousseau. My apologies for getting your name wrong. It is particularly ironic that I should get a Bangladeshi name wrong. So I am doubly sorry. It is now my pleasure to invite Mr. Middleton to say a few words to this gathering.
Thank you, Dr. Dean. Your Excellency, my Lord and Lady Provost, ladies and gentlemen, can I, as one of the patrons of the Bangladesh Association of Northeast Scotland, I think, thank yourselves and the association for inviting us and myself, my wife and some of my fellow citizens to share your celebrations this afternoon of the 14th anniversary of the independence of your country. I was reflecting when Mr. Rasool was speaking and when he spoke in Bengali that you have the advantage over us that you speak two languages, and really it is a sad reflection in our society that we can only speak the one, and really that's something that we should really be doing something to rectify. So we're going to teach Bengali to schools. It should maybe be for Aberdonians as well as for as well as for the Bangladesh community. I would like to say something about the approach of the Education Authority to your school. I and some others have been pushing with some limited success, not as successful as we would have hoped to have been, but there is something here now, there is something coming, and not nearly as much as you would like. I can pledge myself that I'll be continuing to push for that. One of the concerns is, I was told by one official in education, that you see, this is only one ethnic community and there are many in the Northeast, and if one gets these things, then all the others will be looking for it as well. And my answer to that is, well, so what? I mean, that's what it's about, isn't it? You are the biggest ethnic community. For those of my fellow Aberdonians who are here this afternoon and it's your first connection with the Bangladesh Association, can I say that my contact over the past 2 years has been an enriching one for me. I don't know what it's been for the Bengalis, but it's been enriching for me. I found them to be warm, generous, humorous. In fact, very much as I find people from every country. You know, I don't think that people in any country is really all that much different. And I think if we start as well in this country, recognising that and being a bit more outward looking, then possibly a lot of the troubles in the world would go away. I was interested in one thing that was said, was it Dr. Rahman? Said that in Bangladesh, poets can make a good living. I can assure you, speaking from experience, that poets can't make a living in this country, so it may well be that I'll have to emigrate to Bangladesh if I'm going to continue with my poetry. The Lord Provost laughing, you see, he would like me to go to Bangladesh. Many politicians in the Northeast would like me to go to Bangladesh. Can I again, in conclusion, thank you very much for the opportunity of sharing with you this experience today. We're all looking forward to it, and may I offer my congratulations, not only to the formation, but to the continuance of the Bangladesh Association of North East Scotland, and many years, I hope, of my connection with it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Middleton. As he has indicated, he is really helping us quite a lot in the association in various activities, and we appreciate this and we are very thankful to him. It is now my great pleasure to invite Councillor Henry Ray, Lord Provost of Aberdeen, to address this gathering.
Your Excellency, High Commissioner for Bangladesh, to the Aberdeen Bangladesh Association, can I perhaps start by saying welcome. Welcome to the city of Aberdeen. I was casting my eyes carefully over your brochure and it said that Bangladesh has 86,000 agricultural villages, an abundance of water, and there it stops. Because we have an abundance of water, we have agriculture, but we don't have an abundance of sun. It perhaps, as a previous speaker mentioned, that the language barrier is rather difficult. Well, don't abandon hope. There's people in London who don't understand me, and I certainly don't understand them. Perhaps it's important to recognise in Aberdeen and at the time of your celebration that we had an army an imperial army of Gordon Highlanders. So the association between Bangladesh and Aberdeen goes back many years. Perhaps not a very healthy association, but we understood each other on those occasions. And perhaps that is why their acceptance in Aberdeen has been won without any great difficulty. Could I perhaps just highlight one occasion that where we had incomers to Aberdeen? And that was between the wars, after the First World War and prior to the Second World War, that we had a considerable influx of Italians. And when, in the dark days of 1940, that the Italian nation, under a fascist government, decided to join the Nazi Germany and attack Britain, it says something for the tolerance, the understanding of the people of Aberdeen that not one Italian shop was broken or looted, and not one Italian living in Aberdeen was molested or harassed. And that speaks volumes for the tolerance, the understanding in Aberdeen. Because we are a multi-international port. We have had oil, and we are successful. But there's still a basic understanding in Aberdeen that irrespective of colour, creed, religion, identity, that if you join with us to build the city that I'm so justly proud to represent, you will find that there is a great warmth, a feeling of understanding. And can I say, High Commissioner, that your people has integrated to Aberdeen without any great difficulty? Can I perhaps conclude by saying that perhaps as a nation, 500 years ago, we fought for our independence. You were fighting massive powers on either side. We wish you well on your day of celebration. I am certain that Bangladesh will grow in stature, that the economic problems you face today will be overcome. And in fact, we can look forward to a long, glowing relationship between the Bangladesh Society in Aberdeen and Bangladesh in your homeland. We wish you well. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord Provost. In a brief response, we Bangladeshi do appreciate the understanding, tolerance and warmth of the Aberdeenian people. And as I was mentioning in my part, in return, we wish to play a fuller part in the Scottish life. It is now my great pleasure to invite our chief guest, His Excellency Mr. Fakhruddin Ahmed, the High Commissioner of Bangladesh at the Court of St. James. High Commissioner.
Mr. President, Lord Provost of Aberdeen, Lady Provost, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I am extremely happy that I have been able to come today to join you in celebrating the Bangladesh National and Independence Day. I am delighted that my first visit to this lovely city of Aberdeen has coincided with the celebration of our Independence Day, which actually falls on 26th March. While we celebrate 14th year of independence, first of all, we salute millions of our martyrs who sacrificed their lives for achieving freedom and liberty for our people. We remember with gratitude and respect the heroic freedom fighters who so valiantly fought to achieve independence. On this occasion, we also recall with deep appreciation the valuable role of Bangladeshis in Britain, in Scotland, and all over UK in helping substantially by raising funds and mobilizing international opinion, particularly in Scotland and Britain, in our favor. It is in fitness that on this day we convey our deep gratitude and thanks to the people of Scotland, to the people of the entire United Kingdom, for the moral and valuable support and understanding during our darkest period of history. It is now 14th year of independence. We achieved political freedom at a tremendous cost, but we have still a very long way to go before we can achieve economic prosperity. For a population of 96 million, the country has rich potentialities. We have massive deposits of gas, which we are exploiting. We have large deposits of coal, which we have not yet exploited because of the high cost of technology. Besides, we have hard rock and limestone, all of which need successful exploitation. We are continuing exploration, both onshore and offshore, to find oil. The rivers and sea contain huge quantity of fish, out of which shrimps and prawns are largely exported. I have seen some of the ships coming to Dundee bringing fish from Bangladesh. Our agricultural products are also vast. Our export of jute and jute goods, tea, hides and skins, newsprint, occupy our main exports. And in jute and tea, we have a very, very strong link with Scotland. As a developing country, we cannot expand our trade satisfactorily and substantially unless our economy is developed. Aid to underdeveloped countries is therefore vital to develop its economy, but also to develop its trade with the developed world. Aid and investment from developed world to developing countries like Bangladesh are mutually beneficial for the simple fact that if Bangladesh economy is developed, there will be demand for more goods from this country. Bangladesh and Scotland, Bangladesh and UK are Commonwealth partners and share many institutions, traditions, and to some extent part of modern history. The traditional links that took root in economic sense in jute and tea trade, in tea, helped the trade to develop between the two countries, particularly between the two trading communities. Since independence of Bangladesh, opportunities exist further for expansion of trade and investment in various fields, which assume greater importance in the context of our growing relations. The Bangladeshi community living in Scotland provides a very useful link in developing the complementary and mutuality of interest between Scotland, UK and Bangladesh, particularly in the field of economic cooperation. I would like to commend the Bangladesh Association of Northeast Scotland and its members for arranging such a pleasant function. Through various activities like this, the association can effectively project our past and present, our sacrifices, our aims and aspirations, our culture to the host community. It is through such activities that the community can earn respect, cordiality, and greater understanding. I'm particularly happy to see the community in Scotland are working harmoniously and living in peace. Before I conclude, I like to say the community must try to work unitedly for the common cause. Thank you very much. Before I take my departure, may I say just a few words in Bengali? Shudibrindo, আজকে আপনাদের সামনে উপস্থিত হতে পারি এবং আপনাদের সাথে স্বাধীনতা উৎসবে যোগদান করতে পারে আমি অত্যন্ত খুশি। আশা করি আপনারা প্রতি বছর এইভাবে আপনারা স্বাধীনতা উৎসব করবেন। এবং একটা কথা আপনাদের সকলকে বলতে চাই যে আপনাদের ছেলেমেয়েরা যাতে এখানকার ভাষা শেখার সাথে সাথে আমাদের নিজস্ব ভাষা সংস্কৃতিকে না ভুলে সেই দিকে সজাগ রাখবেন, সেই প্রচেষ্টা করবেন, এইটাই আমার আবেদন। ধন্যবাদ।
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. I should have mentioned that Your Excellency have also brought sunshine to Aberdeen because it was snowing yesterday quite heavily. Thank you all very much. This is the end of the... Sorry, it is not quite the end. I thought it is. We are almost near to the end of the proceedings. I would like to invite now Mr. Yasser Razzaq, the President of Bangladesh Association, to give a vote of thanks.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to thank all of guests and the participants. In particular, I would like to express our thanks and gratitude to our guest of honor, His Excellency Mr. Fakhruddin Ahmad, the Bangladesh High Commissioner, and also his entourage for coming all the way from London to grace this occasion. My profound thanks to the Lord Provost of Aberdeen for attending this function and for his kind interest in our efforts. I also appreciate the presence of the Chief Constable of Police of the Grampian region as one of our honored guests. My special thanks are also due to Mr. Middleton, Mr. S.A. Rasool, Professor R. Moore, Dr. A. Rahman, Dr. Astin for their continued assistance. I would like to thank the members of my executive committee and all those who work behind the scene to make this function a success. My thanks also to all for attending this function and to the cultural troupe from London who will present to you a sample of Bangladeshi music and dance after the refreshment. Thanking you all once again.
Gracias. This is a song about the country where I was born, a country I love very much. In it, I have recalled some of my early impressions and memories regarding the natural beauties of the country of my birth. The song sung by Abdul Sabir Lole.
Bangladesh, Rio John Bumi. song from Bangladesh by our child artist, Farzana Sarif Shapla. The song is Kolimun Rohimun, a song Bengal, where those young people of the village, old lang syne of the nostalgia, thinking about the golden days that have gone past, the rivers, the blue sky, the plentiful of grains. Song from Bangladesh. Thank you. minutes tape recorder actually. There will be a dance now.
পালে এক করে মিশে গেছি আমরা সবাই করো পালে
স্বাধীনতার উপরে একটা গান আছে আমাদের অফকোর্স দেয়ার উইল বি প্লেন্টি অফ সেলিব্রিটিস অন ডোন্ট ওয়ারি
Now a special song from Silet district, a chorus song.
Silo ti baisa, ladies and gentlemen, we have slight late change in this program, which is this. We wish this to end the formal part of the function now. So those of you who wish to leave, you can do so now. But this music will continue informally in a typical Bengali way, perhaps for a long time, up to 5:30 or 6. And those of you who wish to stay, please do say stay, but you can leave at any time you wish from now on. So please feel free to do whatever you like. Thank you all for coming.
Hit it. MS first. How this family called it?
আব্দুল সমীর রলেন এখন আমাদেরকে একটি পল্লিগীতি গিয়ে শোনাবে, সিলেটের আঞ্চলিক বাংলা গান।
Okay. Now we play a special song with dance. Our child that will sing a song, and Sujamiya and Malati Sharma will dance with this song. They never practiced before. They only practiced earlier this morning. Yeah, only once. I hope.
Thank you.
শিশু শিল্পীর জন্য গানের জন্য আরেকটা অনুরোধ এসেছে, সিলেটি আঞ্চলিক গানের জন্য। ঠিক আছে, আপনারা শুনবেন? ওকে।
Last song. are the ladies in the common.
Let's go outside, you know. Come to the right.
আমাদের স্বাধীনতা অঙ্গ
উইল কাম ব্যাক এগেইন
আগুন লাগে দুটা।